Okay, it's time to put together flood vehicle number 2 from Hurricane Ida. You can see number 1 is Nissan Rogue. On the previous video, this one is Honda 17 with 14,000 miles. That's the water level. And like I told you many times before, so the fresh water, which is so much vehicle now in the local auctions in New Jersey and Pennsylvania from that recent rains from Hurricane Ida. So it does nothing like to the car, no damage. See, like, you know, tiny, it's just kind of yellowish rust, which just does nothing. And, you know, the carpet was really soaked with water, like really thick carpet, absorb a lot of water. I try to dry it, but it was just probably I don't have enough patience to wait until it's gonna dry, or it will be possible to do during the summer. But now, truthfully, I just give up. I wait like 4 or 5 days. I put it near the heater there. I add another additional couple heaters and blowers and stuff. Nothing. So I just bought new carpet from the dealer. Все там. That's the carpet. And what actually happened? See that insulation? So thick insulation. Upper portion, which is carpet, was absolutely dry. But if you push it really, really hard like that, it's still water. So, you know, maybe during the summer, in the hot summer, I will be able to dry it. But in the winter, I just bought new carpet and that's all. Basically, I, of course, change oil, engine, transmission. You know, we can inspect together. Like, people afraid, oh, it's gonna be problem with the car. What kind of problem? What kind of problem if it was water like that? What? Nothing. Metal? Problem with metal? You can see connectors. No rust, nothing. Just clean, nice connectors because it was fresh water. That's it. You dry it. Make sure this is dry because this is not removable. It go under the dashboard. And that's it. You can see the seat. Under the seat, right? So even here, no rust, and only one small motor was seized because the water touch seats like that probably. So I got new motor. I'm gonna put it now here. Where my new motor? Here we go. New motor going there. New carpet. That's all. Perfect and nice vehicle. So I bought 3 of them. All of them I'm buying only with line, with water level line, because it's, you know, less risk. But I know people buying without those lines because not each of them has this line. And you know, from this local, the recent hurricane, fresh water, all of them perfect. You have to, of course, watch, look on the pictures, make sure it's, you know, you try to estimate the water level, because of course it will, if with water level like this, that vehicle is done. It's not, you will never be able to put it back on the road. It's gonna be just disaster, just total disaster. I bought deep flooded vehicle one, it's parked there outside just for parts. And I paid 3,500 for 19 Subaru Legacy Limited, which is perfect. You know, each door is $5,500, and you know, airbags and suspension and rims and hood and bumper and trunk and, you know, quarter panels. So 3,500 for 19 Subaru is super nice. And I already bought vehicle with front end damage, and I'm gonna use parts. And then I'm gonna buy a vehicle with side damage, I'm gonna use doors, other side damage, rear end damage. So, actually, for salvage market, that hurricane kinda helped a little bit. Okay, so I'm gonna put new motor back, carpet in, clean, and start driving this one. Still waiting for titles.